Where's all the dead fish?
What's that?
Where's all the dead fish?
We've been picking them up. They've been picking them up like crazy. They're putting them in the bins, and then the tide's been washing them. So it looks better today than it was.
But it was here?
Yeah, it was all along here and mostly north of here, but all the way down to Margaret Pace Park too.
Okay.
And there's quite a few of like cleaning efforts of people joining, and there's one at 1 p.m.
Well, good, thanks.
Now if we have good tide, it helps.
We have our water samples here that I took from Morningside and Pelican Marina over by North Bay Village. And I've got this H2O OK complete water analysis kit. Plastic tube. We're gonna fill it up. We're gonna go, this is Morningside. Here we go. 1, 2. Shake. So this one is right around here. So total water hardness is 800. The pH, I would say, is between these two right here. Between 8 and 9. Between 8 and 9. And then as far as the nitrate parts per million, you can see here, it's very low. You can see that the nitrate and the nitrites are very low. It's between zero, I would say, this one is at zero, and this one I would say is at maybe 5. So the nitrate is almost at zero, it's safe. And the nitrate is between 5 and 0. So it says acceptable standard 10. So it's safe. All right, so it's been a good 30 seconds. The copper test here, you can see I'm holding it. And it's pretty much right here. You can see what I'm doing right here. It's 0.6. Okay, acceptable is 1.3. So this one is like at 0.6. Copper, 0.6. So again, the copper passes. All right, it's been 60 seconds. The iron strip, you can see right there, it's pretty much zero. River water supplies in the Delta of Congo, Vietnam, Bangladesh, blah, blah, blah. It is common for river delta water to have a total dissolved solids, TDS, content that fluctuates from 80 milligrams to 12,000 milligrams due to the seasonal seawater refilling. This water is generally categorized as high salinity brackish water. So look, fresh water should be less than 500 milligrams, good quality. Marginal water, 500 to 1500. So the test that we just did that shows that it's around 800 is pretty much right. Yeah, so you need 50 for drinking water, but for bay water, which is kind of brackish, 800 sounds about right. It's been 10 minutes pulling out the tow strips. So here's that one, and here's this one. So the lead is slightly showing, but there's not much going on over here. In order for it to be positive, you need two solid blue lines. And there's a very faint one and an even more faint two. So there is a tiny trace of lead, but not enough to be on the positive side. It's really more over here on the negative side. So there's a tiny trace of lead in the water, but it's still on the negative end. And as far as the pesticide is concerned, there's nothing. There's nothing showing up. Very faint lines. So the pesticide is a negative and the lead is a negative. So pesticide negative, lead negative. That says acceptable 15 parts per billion or whatever. I mean, I don't know what this means over here, but it's a negative. And we're waiting on that one. So everything checks out. Total hardness, 800 parts per million. And for brackish water, that's right where it needs to be. Chlorine, zero. Alkalinity, 120 parts per million. pH, between an 8 and a 9. Nitrate, safe. It was 0.1. Nitrate, also safe, 0.2. Copper, 0.6, which is safe. And iron, 0.01, which is safe. So the water checks out. Everything checks out. There's nothing really out of the ordinary here. The water checks out. So it's none of these pesticides or fertilizers, which you guys are worried about. You guys are saying that it's pesticides, the nitrates, and the fertilizers. According to this test, it's safe, so it's not a big deal.
How dare you!